Okay, welcome to this next lecture on second order circuit. We started the second order circuit in the previous lecture where we discuss the series RLC network and we discuss the natural response. Now, in this particular lecture, we will focus on parallel RLC circuit and then we'll cover the natural response of the parallel RLC circuit. So, if we have a resistance, inductance and capacitance in parallel, then what happened to the voltage and the current under the natural response condition? Natural response condition means if there is initial voltage in the capacitor and initial current in the inductor, how the system will respond for a parallel RLC network. So the current that is flowing in the inductor and the voltage in the capacitor are basically assumed to be the initial condition, and then we are going to write the equation by applying the KCL equation at the top node. So you know that KCL equation is algebraic sum of all the current at a particular node is equal to zero. So we can write the equation as the current which is passing through the resistance is V by R, where the voltage of the inductor, capacitor and resistor remains the same as all are in parallel. The current through the inductor we can write 1 by L integration of the voltage, and the current through the capacitor we can write C dV by dt. Now on the right hand side of the equation we have zero term since we are finding the natural response of the circuit, no external source is there. The equation is basically the integral differential equation. We have to convert the equation into differential equation form. Then we need to derivate this equation to obtain the differential equation in the standard format. So we are getting the second order differential equation. Since the power of the voltage, maximum power of the differential of the voltage is 2, so it is a second order differential equation and the circuit is parallel RLC network. Now, if we change the di by dt term with a variable s, which is known as the Laplace variable. This we are going to study in more deep when we will study the AC domain. So the s is known as the Laplace variable. So d2 by dt square will be the term which is known as the s square. So this equation we can write in the compact form is equal to s square plus 1 by RC into s plus 1 by LC, where s is basically d by dt term and known as the Laplace variable. So once we get this equation, we can find the roots of this characteristic equation s square plus 1 by RC into s plus 1 by LC equal to 0. We will get two roots because the order of the equation is 2. So the two roots are minus 1 by 2 RC plus minus, some terms are there, which is 1 by 2 RC square minus 1 by LC. The two roots can be written in the compact form in the form of minus alpha. We have a plus minus sign under root alpha square minus omega naught square, where the value of alpha is equal to 1 by 2 RC and omega naught is equal to 1 by under root LC. We have introduced this value of alpha and omega naught in the previous lecture itself, where we were discussing the series RLC network. The omega naught is constant, which is same as the 1 by under root LC, whereas there is a change in the value of alpha as compared to the series RLC network. Now let us see the response cases that we have studied in the previous lecture itself. The overdamped case when alpha is greater than omega naught and L is greater than 4 R square C, the roots of the characteristic equations are real and negative, and the response is in the form of a1 e to the power s1t plus a2 e to the power s2t, where s1 and s2 are the two roots and a1 and a2 are coming from the boundary condition constants. Critically damped case, alpha is equal to omega naught when L is equal to 4 R square C, the roots are real and equal, and we will be getting the roots in the form of a1 plus a2t e to the power minus alpha t. Now, if we have the underdamped case where alpha is less than omega naught, when L is less than 4 r square c, the roots are complex and it will be written in the form of minus alpha plus minus j omega d, where the damping frequency is equal to under root of omega naught square minus alpha square. So the equation that we are getting for the response here is damped and oscillatory, which is known as the ringing effect. We have e to the power minus alpha t a1 cos omega dt plus a2 sin omega dt. So this is for the overdamped case, this is for the critically damped case, and this is for the underdamped case. So these three cases will be dependent on the value of R, that is known as the damping value or the lossless value, which will govern the alpha. We have introduced this in the previous lecture, how the resistance plays a very important role in governing the system to be overdamped, critically damped or underdamped cases. The constant A1 and A2 we can find out from the initial condition of voltage at the initial condition 0 and dV by dt at the initial condition 0, that is during the switching instant. We'll solve one problem to understand this RLC network in parallel and how the cases change the responses. So we have a resistance, inductance and capacitance, all are in parallel with the initial current and initial voltage of the inductor and the capacitor. We have to determine the response V of t for all time t greater than 0 when given condition is that the initial voltage is 5 volt. So as I said also in the previous lecture, that when we talk about the voltage, it is always the capacitor voltage. So initial voltage of the capacitor is 5 volt and the initial current, which is the current of the inductor, is equal to 0 ampere when the switching has taken place or the instant is zero. Here the circuit is under the natural response condition since we do not have any external source present. Now the inductor value is given 1 Henry and capacitor value is given 10 millifarad. We have to obtain the response under the different cases of the resistance, which is equal to 1.923 ohms, 5 ohms and 6.25 ohms. We will see that in this particular problem how with the change in this resistance with a different value, the response of the network, that is V of t, how it is changing. So let us look into the solution. Case 1, we will take the resistance to be 1.923 ohms. What will happen? So first we are going to determine the value of alpha. Alpha is equal to 1 by 2 RC from the formulae. We have to put the value of the resistance and capacitance, we'll get 26. Omega naught, the frequency, is equal to 1 by under root LC is equal to 10, and these remain constant for all the cases, that is 1, 2 and 3. So we are going to take 3 cases, and for all the 3 cases the omega naught is constant because it is not dependent on the resistance parameter. It is only dependent on the inductance and capacitance, which is constant throughout. Only the resistance is changing. Now let us check the condition. We find that alpha is greater than omega naught. These indicate that the system is overdamped. If alpha is greater than omega naught, the system is overdamped. It means that we have to determine the roots of the characteristic equation, which is equal to minus alpha plus minus under root of alpha square minus omega naught square. We'll get two roots, minus 2 and minus 50. Here also you can see that roots are real and with a negative value. Okay, now the general response of the overdamped system V of t is given by a1 e to the power s1t plus a2 e to the power s2t, where s1 and s2 are the two roots which we have substituted here, the two roots. Now our work is to determine the constants a1 and a2, which we will get from the boundary condition. The first boundary condition we can get from putting the value of time is equal to 0. When we put the time to be 0, then we'll get the first equation, which is a1 plus a2 is equal to 5 in this particular equation of voltage. Second, dV by dt term. So this is the equation that we have got from the parallel RLC network of the voltage, which we can substitute the value of the initial voltage and initial current in the equation. we will get minus 260 as dv by dt. Now, the equation of the voltage, we will differentiate dv by dt, this equation, and try to determine what is the function. So, the function that we are getting on differentiating the voltage, we can substitute the value of dv by dt here under the initial condition, which is minus 260. Then we will get the second equation of the boundary condition, which is minus 260 is equal to minus 2A1 minus 50A2. That is the first condition is A1 plus A2 is equal to 5. And second case that we are getting. So first boundary condition we are getting from V of 0. And second boundary condition we are getting from dV by dt 0. Once we get the two boundary condition, that is the two constant in two equations, we can solve the value of A1 and A2. Once we have got the value of A1 and A2, now we can substitute that in the equation of voltage. So the final solution to the voltage equation, we have got it when the resistance is equal to 1.923 ohms and the response is overdamped. Now let us take the case 2. Case 2 is resistance is 5 ohms. What is happening? Alpha will change because alpha depends upon the resistance. We will substitute and try to get the value of alpha, that is 10. Omega naught, which remains the same throughout, as it is not dependent on the resistance, it is dependent on the inductance and capacitance. And we will decide what type of response is this. Since alpha and omega naught are equal, which is 10, the response is critically damped response. We have decided the type of the response. Now we will find the roots of the equation S1 and S2 from the equation. So S1 and S2 root, we have got minus 10. Now the general equation of the voltage we know for the critically damped case, which is A1 plus A2t e to the power st. Now here the roots are real and equal. Now we will determine the constants A1 and A2. First equation that we are getting from the initial condition of voltage, where substituting the value of time equal to 0 in the voltage equation. Second, we have dV by dt equation, which gives us to be 100, minus 100. Now, differentiate the voltage equation dV by dt. You will get the function of dV by dt term in the time domain. Substitute the value of dV0 by dt of minus 100 in the equation. So we have the second equation in the A1, A2 term. So we have two constant in two equations that we can solve to find the value of A1 and A2. Once we have got the value of A1 and A2, we can substitute that in the general equation of the critically damped case. So second case we have taken where resistance is equal to 5 ohm, response is critically damped, and the voltage response we have obtained. Now the third and the final case where the resistance is equal to 6.25 ohms, we are going to see what is happening. When alpha is equal to 1 by 2 RC, that we have to determine is equal to 8, omega naught remain the same, which is 10. We have to determine what type of response is this, where alpha is less than omega naught, the system is underdamped. Determine the roots S1 and S2. We know that for the underdamped system, the roots will be complex and we will have the real part and imaginary part. Both the real part and imaginary part are required to determine the voltage equation, which is the general equation of the underdamped case. So general case, we will be substituting the value of alpha and omega d. So here the 6 is basically the omega d, that is the damping frequency. Then we get the general response of the underdamped case. Now the time is to determine the constant. So the first equation that we are getting from substituting the value of the time to be 0 in the equation of the voltage, and dV by dt at 0 condition, we know the formula, which will give us minus 80. Now you differentiate the voltage equation dV by dt and get the another function of t. Substitute the value of dv by 0 by dt at 0th condition, that is time to be 0, we will get the second equation. So two equations we have got in a1 and a2 that will help us to find the constant a1 and constant a2, and then we can substitute in the final solution of the underdamped case. So we will be getting the three solution for the three cases, and we will be seeing that when we are changing the value of the resistance for the case 1, case 2 and case 3, we have got different type of response, that is the voltage on the y-axis with respect to time. The responses are overdamped, critically damped and underdamped. And we know that critically damped response is basically the borderline, which is the most fastest, and overdamped system is the sluggish, which is very slow, and underdamped system is between. Generally, in the day-to-day life, all the systems that we have, generally the systems are underdamped case, will be there, the response. So the transients will die out and reach the steady state condition. So this is where the steady state is there, and this part of the response is basically transient, which dies out and reach the steady state. So these transients are the natural response due to the voltage and current which is present in the inductor and the capacitor. So in this particular lecture, we focus our discussion on the parallel RLC network and the natural response we have taken. In the next lecture, we'll focus on the step response.